What's going on, fishing buddies? Welcome back to the channel. Finally got a break in the weather. I've been up since about 5:15 a.m. watching the radar, waiting for this storm to pass. It is 8:05 a.m. now, and I'm finally loaded up, headed to the beach. I'm gonna hit one of my favorite little fishing spots here in Perdido. It's kind of a pain to get to, but it usually pays off. Let's get it out there. All right, guys, we have definitely got some chop out there left over from the storm. Looks like the current is pushing east. Water looks fairly clean from here, but I definitely believe this is going to be a 4-ounce sinker guy Sputnik day just because of the chop. The goal is to pull something home to eat. Let's get unloaded. I got these little, I believe they're man-o-wars, all over the beach. They're super small, but they will still get you, and they're washed up everywhere. That storm must have brought them in. I really gotta watch my step, because that will put you down for a minute. This is my little spot I like to come. It's got a lot of activity right here in this concentrated area. It's been like this for about a month in this same spot. So out of curiosity, I'm gonna sling some lead through there, burn it back, and see if I can pick up anything. Got a rod bend on my pompano rod. I finally put some pompano rods out. Oh yeah, this one's got some weight to it, y'all. Come on, is he running in on me? Yeah, he's running in. All right, what do we got? Oh, what do we got? What do we got? Come on up. Oh, big old cat. All right, it's gonna be catfishy out there, I believe. All right, not what we wanted. There we go, another hit on my other pompano rod, completely different direction. He doesn't look like it's gonna be much, but we got activity. Where you at? It might have come off. Another little cat. No, that's a little whiting. That's a little whiting. That's what we're after. Nice. He hit the purple and white Frisky Fins PB rig on the new color combo from Fish Bites. That is a clam flavor, purple and white. That guy might make 10 inches. I don't believe so. I believe I'm just gonna use him for cut bait and get it on my drum rod. When it's rough like this, guys, it's important to always kind of dislodge these sinker guy Spudniks, because they'll get sucked down in there. So about every 10 minutes or so, I'll come dislodge them, reset them, just so they don't get so sunk in there that it's hard to get back out. Find my 5-inch sword. It's one of my favorite sword products. This is a 5-inch little bait knife. This thing is awesome. Goes on the kayak, goes surf fishing. Everywhere I go fishing, this guy goes. I've had this guy, I'm gonna say over 6 months, and I've never felt the need to sharpen it. It's still sharp. It's got that signature sword grip handle on it. Beautiful little sheath with the belt clip. Super important for me. And this is what'll take care of this whiting for cut bait. Beautiful product. Got that whiting head on this drum rod now. This is a single drop, 40 pound. Oh. I might have did this one 30. This feels like 30 pound. So 30 pound leader, got a 4-ounce Sputnik on this guy, 5,000 series reel, 30 pound true braid on a 12-foot Frisky Fins custom, which is on a Ninja Dagger blank. Could be a red running around out there in this rough water. Just got a text message from my buddy Joe, who's down the beach here. He told me he's picked a few off as far out as he could throw on Easy Flea Fish Bites. He said that's the only thing they've been hitting. Looks like he's been out here all morning. I waited for the rain. I waited for the rain to stop. Joe's a trooper. So I'm gonna pull up my pompano rods and just give them a launch. I got 4 ounces of weight on both of them on these 11-foot Ninja Daggers. And I find that 4 ounces is a sweet spot for these rods for a good hefty launch.
This rod is twitching. Definitely nothing big. There you go. What are you? Might be another little whiting. Let's see. Come here. Come here. There we go. Had to get that sinker unlodged. I am in the process of leapfrogging everything east. I had trouble deciding which way I wanted to go because the only two hits I've got have been on my end rod. So my furthest rod west and my furthest rod east have been the two that's been hit. Nice whiting. That will keep. Again, on that purple and white PB float with the purple and white clam fish bites. Yeah, he'll keep. I'll try to pull in a few more. We'll have us a good little lunch. All right, looks like another little whiting hit. Oh, lost my flip flop. Don't want to step on these jellyfish. Come on in, come here. Could be another keeper. I don't feel much. He might have wiggled off. Yeah, I think so. Man, go deep with this one again. As soon as it hit, guys, look at this. As soon as it hit, all right, we're not losing this one. Come here. Oh, this is a good one, y'all. This is a good one. Okay, they might be getting active. I mean, as soon as I set it in the sand spike, he went off again. This one's head shaking the whole way in. Come on in, buddy. Come on, he's not running to the side. So I don't believe we got a pump. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I hope it's not a catfish. Come on. Oh, I got another one going off. Oh, I might be crossed up. That is a little pump. That's a little pump. He ain't gonna be a keeper. All right, they're out there. He hit that sand flea fish bites, just like my buddy Joe told me. Could be schooling. I'm gonna launch it right back out. Same spot. Get this guy back. Nice. Pretty slow out there. Two whiting, that baby pomp, and my PB catfish. I've given it a solid 2 hours. But I packed it up and I wanted to use this opportunity to talk about something that's been on my mind as I've been preparing for tax season. I am living 100% solely off of side hustles. Like, I guess a traditional side hustle would be you have like your primary job, your primary income, your 40-hour week, 9-to-5 with your insurance and your benefits. Then you got something maybe you do at night or on the weekend. Could be cutting grass, could be electrical work, could be whatever for side money. That's your side hustle. I just have a bunch of side hustles. I don't have a primary job. It hasn't always been like this. I worked in the mental health field for years. And then PERDIDOBLANE Outfitters, the guides, was my side hustle. Once I went full time for that, it will be a year this April. I've created a lot of different things under that umbrella. So obviously I have the guide service, right? So the surf fishing guides and the kayak fishing guides. The YouTube videos, content creation produces a little bit of money a month and it's very small. I have a few paid deals with sponsors. I've recently got into bed with Oceanwave Sunglasses, managing their social media. So that's another source of income. And the wife and I are creating something new under that umbrella, which we are gonna develop over the next 6 months. And this is something that's probably gonna take like a small business loan to get going. But again, that will fall under the umbrella of PERDIDOBLANE Outfitters also. Now my guide business does produce like the bulk of the income, but could I survive on it alone? You know, family of four, just the guide business? Probably not. So I have like my main side hustle, and then I got a bunch of little side hustles underneath that, which includes some restaurant work. I do some front of the house restaurant work like twice a week. So really that is like the only building that I have to go to, that I actually have to report to. Everything else is kind of like on my time. And guys, I love it. If I can get away with it, I will never go back to a traditional like 9-to-5 work. Working for somebody, following the rules, just not interested. But with just living off a bunch of side hustles, you know, there are some disadvantages. I have to find my own insurance. I have to save for the future. Like, there's no money coming out of my check for 401k. So I have to be disciplined in all that to prepare for the future. Do I believe PERDIDOBLANE Outfitters will make it? Absolutely. My wife is very supportive of what we're doing. She has some side hustles. A lot of y'all know Mahdi. She has her business, Mahdi Turado Art, which falls under her Lily Craft Corporation. And we are constantly busy. There are a few moments in the house that we are really not talking about business or working on something business related. Running that many side hustles is very time consuming. But again, it is on my time, which is delicious. This is what like an average day of PERDIDOBLANE looks like. I get up about 5:15, I'm out of the house by 5:45, and I'm fishing. This is running charters or personal fishing. I fish till about 10 a.m., I pack it up, I head home. Get everything cleaned up, take a shower, maybe eat. Now I'm on the computer. I'm offloading footage from the cameras. I'm answering emails that have to do with other side hustles. And basically I'm stuck behind that computer probably for the next 4 to 5 hours. Moving in towards the night, Mahdi and I usually are having some discussions on whatever's going on with the day, whatever's coming up. We got a trip to Atlanta Beach, Florida, probably in about 3 weeks for fishing and ocean waves related stuff. So there's the planning of all that. And we constantly got something going on like that. We are never sitting around watching TV like with nothing to do. When I was just working 9-to-5s, that's really what my life was. I would work my 9-to-5, I would get off, we would do dinner, soccer practice, watch TV. On the weekends, I would fish. It's freaking boring. There is a lot of hustle in me, there is a lot of hustle in Mahdi, and because of that, we're able to manage all this stuff. And steadily looking to add more. I love displaying this stuff to my kids, showing them that you don't necessarily have to go the traditional route. If you got some creativity, if you got some hustle, if you got the willpower, if you got some discipline, you can do this and be your own boss. I don't want my kids working for nobody. I don't want to work for nobody. I want to be the ruler of my domain. And it's working, guys. And like I said, you have your good months, you have your bad months, but you prepare for the bad ones. Are we always the best at that? No. But we're learning year after year about the seasons. I mean, my main source of income is tourism. So really figuring out the pockets of when there is just nobody here, and it's not a lot. It seems like it is, but it's really not. There's always something going on that brings tourists into this area, into this panhandle area. You know, my neck of the woods, Perdido Key, Orange Beach, Alabama. I also run guides in Pensacola if necessary. I don't necessarily like going over there to run guides because it's like an hour for me. I like things close and quick. Again, yeah, this dawned on me as I had a meeting with my tax guy last week, and he asked me what my main source of income was. I couldn't tell him. I was like, I got a bunch of sources of income that it's all kind of come together at the end of the month. And that's when I realized, like, I'm just living off side hustles. Beautiful lifestyle, guys. Wouldn't trade it for the world. You guys have shown me so much support over the last few years. I constantly see things growing, and myself and my family are very appreciative of that. Time to go get on the computer. Ah. Till next time, fishing buddies.